Tamil chapter. In this video I explain here the relationship between the zeros and the coefficient of a polynomial. We already seen the zero of a linear polynomial. Linear polynomial is ax plus b. Zero of this linear polynomial ax plus b is minus b by a. So what is b and what is a? Here x coefficient is a and the b is a constant term. So here the zero of this linear polynomial is minus b by a, where a is the x coefficient and b is the constant term. So see here, zero of ax plus b, the linear polynomial ax plus b, is equal to minus b by a. Now this is the zero. Now see the relation here, minus b means constant term, b means constant, and a means x coefficient. Here the a is x coefficient. So this is the relation between the zero and the coefficients of the linear polynomial. Now I will try to explore the relationship between the zeros and the coefficient of a quadratic polynomial. So before starting this relation, see, I use some Greek letters here. The Greek letters are alpha, and this letter is read as beta, and the third one is here gamma. Third one is gamma. So I use these letters to represent the zeros of a polynomial. See, alpha, beta and gamma. Let alpha, comma, beta are zeros of a quadratic polynomial. Zeros of a quadratic polynomial f of x equal to ax square plus bx plus c. If these are the zeros of a quadratic polynomial, then from factor theorem, so what is the factor theorem? Then from factor theorem, x minus alpha and x minus beta are the factors of the polynomial f of x. Then we have the f of x is written as like this. K into x minus alpha into x minus beta. See, once again, if alpha comma beta are the zeros of a quadratic polynomial f of x, ax square plus bx plus c, then from factor theorem, x minus alpha and x minus beta are the factors of f of x. If they are the factors of f of x, then it is written as f of x equal to k into x minus alpha into x minus beta. Now in the place of f of x, write the quadratic polynomial ax square plus bx plus c equal to k into, put k as it is, now multiply x with the two terms, x minus beta. First x into x, x square minus x into beta, beta x. Next minus alpha with the two terms, minus alpha into x, alpha x, minus into minus, plus alpha into beta, alpha beta. Now k as it is, x square as it is. Now here minus beta x minus alpha x. So here minus minus common, and xx is also x common. So minus x common. So write the remaining terms here, minus alpha x minus common. So here the alpha remaining. Next here minus beta x minus and x common. So here the beta into x plus alpha beta. Now next multiply with the k with the three terms, k into x square minus k into alpha plus beta into x. Next plus k into alpha beta. Now left side ax square plus bx plus c. Now comparing x square comma x coefficients and constant term. See, after writing this, multiply the x minus alpha into x minus beta, we get the here the relation k into x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. Now multiply with the k. Now here the comparing x square comma x coefficients and the constant term. See the compare first here x square coefficient right side k, here x square coefficient left side a. So a equal to k. Say equation 1. Next compare the x coefficient left side b, right side x coefficient minus k into alpha plus beta. Say this is equation number 2. Now next constant term. Constant term left side c, right side constant term k into alpha beta. Now this is equation number 3. Now see, divide equation 2 by 1. Now do 2 by 1. Equation 2, right side, sorry, first left side b, equation 1 left side a equal to equation 2 right side minus k into alpha plus beta by equation 1 right side k. So here k cancel, then see we have alpha plus beta equal to, transpose this negative right left side, then this is minus b by a, alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a. Now this is the first relation. Next same, in the same way do 3 by 1, equation 3 by equation 1. Now left side of equation 3 is c, right left side of equation 1 by a equal to, now right side of equation 3 k into alpha beta by equation 1 right side is k cancel. Now from this right alpha beta equal to alpha into beta equal to c by a. Now this is the relation alpha beta equal to c by a. Now see from this we have alpha beta. Alpha beta are the zeros of the polynomial. So here alpha plus beta means sum of the zeros. Alpha beta means see sum of the zeros of the given polynomial f of x, sum of the zeros of f of x equal to alpha plus beta. So sum of the zeros of the given polynomial f of x equal to alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a. Minus as it is, what is b in polynomial? Here quadratic polynomial ax square plus bx plus c. So this is for f of x. B means x coefficient. Here the b means x coefficient by a. A means x square coefficient. Now this is the relation between the zero and the coefficient, means the sum of the zeros of the polynomial f of x, quadratic polynomial, is alpha plus beta is minus b by a. Minus as it is, b means x coefficient, a means x square coefficient. At the second relation, alpha into beta equal to c by a. Alpha into beta means product of the zeros of f of x equal to alpha into beta. Product of the zeros means alpha into beta equal to here c by a. What is c? C means constant term. C means constant by a means again the same x square coefficient. Now this is relation between zeros and the coefficient of a quadratic. Remember, see the sum of the zeros of f of x equal to alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a equal to minus x coefficient by x square coefficient. And the product of the zeros of f of x equal to alpha into beta equal to c by a to constant by x square coefficient. Now it is important, the formula sum of the zeros alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a and the product of the zeros alpha into beta equal to c by a. In exercise 3.3, complete first bit related to only this formula, depends on this formula. See, also we have one more relation. If alpha comma beta are zeros of the polynomial zeros of the polynomial f of x, quadratic polynomial f of x, then f of x is written as like this. Then f of x equal to k into, it is written as like this, k into x minus alpha x minus beta. From this we have a one more important formula, k into, it is written as x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha into beta. See, it is related to the second bit problems. Look, in exercise 3.3, complete second bit depends only on this formula. If alpha comma beta are the zeros of a quadratic polynomial f of x, then the quadratic polynomial is written as like this, f of x equal to k into x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha into beta. And it is also written as like this, f of x equal to k into x square minus alpha plus beta, means alpha comma beta are the zeros. Alpha plus beta means sum of the zeros into x plus alpha into beta. Alpha comma beta are the zeros, so alpha into beta means product of the zeros means alpha comma beta are the zeros. Are, if alpha comma beta the zeros are given of a polynomial, quadratic polynomial f of x, then it is written as like this, where k is some constant, k equal to some constant, it depends on the values of alpha and beta. Now see here, again the relationship between the zeros and the coefficient of a cubic polynomial. The cubic polynomial, same, let alpha, beta and gamma, alpha, beta and gamma are the zeros of a cubic polynomial. Zeros of a cubic polynomial. The cubic polynomial is f of x equal to ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d, where a not equal to 0. Alpha, beta, gamma are the zeros of a cubic polynomial f of x equal to ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d, where a not equal to 0. Then from factor theorem we have x minus alpha, x minus beta and x minus gamma. X minus alpha, x minus beta and x minus gamma are the factors of polynomial, cubic polynomial f of x. Then the f of x is written as like this, f of x equal to same model as the quadratic polynomial, k into x minus alpha into x minus beta into x minus gamma, same as the quadratic polynomial. It is also same in the cubic polynomial, also same. If they are the factors, then the cubic polynomial is written as like this, f of x equal to k into x minus alpha, x minus beta, x minus gamma, where k equal to some constant. Now here I am writing directly after the multiplication of these three terms, then the polynomial, the cubic polynomial is like this, x cube minus alpha plus beta plus gamma into x square plus alpha into beta plus beta into gamma plus gamma into alpha into x minus alpha into beta into gamma, means after the multiplication of these three terms, now the polynomial is like this. So this is a cubic polynomial, ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. Now multiply with k, right side, k into x cube minus k into alpha plus beta plus gamma into x square plus k into alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha into x. Next k into the last term, k into alpha beta gamma. Now comparing the coefficients, the same as the quadratic polynomial, comparing x cube, x square, x coefficients, x coefficients and the constant term. See, compare the coefficients. The left side x cube coefficient is a. Now right side x cube coefficient is k. Next x square coefficient is b. Left side, right side x square coefficient minus k into alpha plus beta plus gamma. Next left side x coefficient c, right side x coefficient k into alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha. Next constant term d equal to right side constant term minus k into alpha beta gamma. So this is equation 1, equation 2, equation 3, equation 4. Now in the same as quadratic polynomial, we have to form a relation among these coefficients with zeros. Do same as a quadratic polynomial. First divide equation 2 by equation 1. See equation 2 left side. Left side equation 2b and left side equation by a. Now right side equation 2 minus k into alpha plus beta plus gamma by equation 1 right side k. K cancel. Now transpose minus left side. Then we have a relation alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to the sum of the zeros of a cubic polynomial. Alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to minus b by a. So this is the first relation, alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to minus b by a. Next do 3 by 1, equation 3 by equation 1. Equation 3 left side c, equation 1 left side a. Equation 3 right side k into alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha by equation 1 right side k cancel. Now from this we have alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha equal to c by a. So product of the two zeros, alpha beta means product of the two zeros, sum of the product of the two zeros taken at a time is equal to c by a. Now equation 4 by equation 1, equation 4 left side value d, equation 1 left side value a equal to equation 4 right side minus k into alpha beta gamma by equation 1 right side k cancel, transpose minus left side. Then we have the relation alpha into beta into gamma, the product of the zeros. Alpha into beta into gamma means product of the zeros of a cubic polynomial equal to minus d by a. Now this is the third relation. So alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to minus b by a. Alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha equal to c by a. Alpha into beta into gamma equal to minus d by a. See, from the previous complete relation, I explain the once again. See, if alpha, beta, gamma are zeros of cubic polynomial f of x equal to ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d, where a not equal to 0, then we have sum of the zeros of cubic polynomial f of x equal to alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to minus b by a. Here minus b means, see, relation here the zeros with the coefficient. B means x square coefficient by a means x cube coefficient. A means x cube coefficient. So this is the relation between the zero and with the coefficients. Next, sum of the product of the zeros taken two at a time means alpha into beta plus beta into gamma plus gamma into alpha equal to c by a. C means x coefficient, a means x cube coefficient. So c means x coefficient by a. A means x cube coefficient. A means x cube coefficient. Now this is the relation between the zeros with the coefficient. And the last one, product of the zeros. Product of the zeros. Product of the zeros equal to alpha into beta into gamma equal to minus d by a. Alpha into beta into gamma equal to minus d by a. What is d? D means constant term. D means constant, constant by a. A means x cube coefficient. A means x cube coefficient. Now this is the relation between the zeros with the coefficient of a cubic polynomial. In exercise 3.3, we have fourth bit related to these relations.